Okay, so now we're going to talk about the fossils in chapter 11. So in chapter 10, we focused on Homo erectus. And so you can kind of see that still they're around the same size, but we're going to see an even bigger increase in brain size starting here. So I just wanted to give you kind of a comparison between all of them. This is Homo erectus. I'm going to move him off to the side. We're going to talk about these two skulls, which are the archaic Homo sapien species. We have Homo heidelbergensis. This is the one who was found in Europe and used the Levallois tools. And then Homo neanderthalensis, or the Neanderthals found in Europe and the Middle East that used Mousterian tools. And then we have here a very early modern Homo sapien. So I want to kind of go over a few of the key features of these skulls. First, for heidelbergensis, you can see that there is an even increased brain size and a little bit rounder skull, although overall still kind of chunky and robust and still has those brow ridges, the supraorbital brow ridges. One thing that's very interesting about heidelbergensis is the teeth. They're filed down. And so this is evidence of making clothing. When you're living in Europe in an ice age and you've lost all of your hair, as we learned with Homo erectus, you're going to need to put some kind of protection on your body. And so this is evidence of them using animal hides to make clothing, holding it in their mouth, and that slowly kind of rubbing back and forth as they made that clothing. Also remember about heidelbergensis, we have evidence of burial using a pink hand axe. So that's something that's very interesting. Again, with Homo naledi, we see possible burial in a cave, but with heidelbergensis and Neanderthals, we're seeing burials much further back. These are hundreds of thousands of years old. We're also seeing them buried in the ground in purposefully dug pits. So a standard burial as we would think of it. The Neanderthal, as you can see, compared to a human, is much larger. Even though their body size was a little shorter, they are using Bergman's rule for living in an Arctic environment. They're short and stocky. They have a very robust, thick, kind of wide chest, and they're very, very muscular. They also have a very, very large brain size and kind of a barrel-shaped head. On the back here is very important. You have the occipital bun for that extra neck and shoulder muscle. And on the front, you have a very wide nasal opening. This is also going to be Allen's rule, where you have a very large nose for an Arctic climate. Finally, we come to Homo sapiens. This is the modern Homo sapien. These were found in Europe around 30 to 40,000 years ago. Cro-Magnon man is your good example of that. The couple of features I want you to know about Homo sapiens, they have this nice, very round, globular skull. Most importantly, they do not have these big brow ridges. They have a vertical forehead, and we humans have a chin. The bottom of our mandible sticks straight forward. I know it's not super exciting, but that's kind of the defining feature of Homo sapiens, is the chin sticks straight forward. If we look at a Neanderthal jaw, it doesn't do that. It goes straight down. And if we look at heidelbergensis, it actually recedes backwards. So one way that's very easy to identify a Homo sapien, a modern Homo sapien, is going to be with the jaw. You're also going to be analyzing the DNA between Neanderthals and humans because we do share some DNA that overlaps, showing that we were able to interbreed. And so that brings up the question of whether we really can call ourselves different species.